cleared Winchester of the Order. Yet to do so meant working with King Alfred.
Your poor fellow soldier led you to the King of Wessex? How very strange. He, or she, is toying with you, it seems.
I have to go.
Then go in peace.
You're a good boy.
Good day.
The Order in Winchester has been wiped out, but we are no longer welcome there. My contact was none other than King Alfred himself. The Order wanted him dead, so he fought back.
Alfred, the line between friend and enemy is a porous one.
Eivor, the time has come. Our time.
Our time for what?
My final glory awaits.
Your final glory? I fear to ask what that means.
Do I not speak plainly? My time in Midgard is done. I wish now to see the hall of my ancestors.
If you wish to die, it will not be by my hand.
I do not speak of death, Eivor. I speak of life. Life and glory everlasting. I know I've been in a fog these last few weeks. I know I speak words you don't fully understand. But I only ask you trust me once more. On my final voyage, back to Norway, to wish my father farewell and achieve my destiny.
Back to Norway. I need to discuss this with Ranvi.
If you must. I will await your answer down by the docks. Do not keep me waiting.
Good to see you, darling.
I want to see the Alliance map. It may be time to return to Norway. Sigurd is eager to see his father and beyond that, I do not know.
I have heard ill news about Styrbjorn in the past year. If you go, go with care.
We'll leave now and return as soon as we're able.
Good. And be safe, both of you.
Sigurd.
Shall we then, Eivor? To Norway, and well beyond.
To Norway, then.
Good, good! Lead on!
Us more than all the decades we spend here, brother.
It's bloody cold. Colder than I remember. This is Harald's Fairhair's kingdom now. Every peak and fjord. It pains me to say it. To think it even.
And our father, his fool. Poor man.
It is a role he chose. He bent easily and broke in half. Do not pity him.
No.
For many moons I could not sleep, always thinking of his betrayal. The horrors I wished upon him. He deserves nothing but shame now.
Put it out of your mind, Sigurd. There's no need to hound the old man.
No. He must taste the same foulness that I taste. He must know what glory he missed by staying here, the lapdog of a conqueror.
You want to speak with him?
Yes. Face to face. I will tell him the truth. Alrekstad. It thrives. In spite of our father, no doubt.
Are you sure of this?
I will say what needs to be said.
Do you fear his rebuke?
Oh, no. I crave it. It may be the old hound has lost his bark.
Or it may be you light a fire beneath him, inspire him with tales of our glory.
If I do, I'll stoke that flame until it burns.
Pull up here!
Hey!
What was it Randy said? Our father spends his days in the mead halls, and his nights on barren planks of wood.
That's right.
We'll search the mead halls.
I remember one nearby. A sad hall where men soak their unhappiness.
We should look there.
We come empty-handed. Not even a gift to offer.
Rats don't appreciate gifts. They sniff and lick them. Without care.
You are chipper, brother. Show me.
That poor soaker, he never is with us.
From sunup to sundown, he just sits.
We should go. Look at him.
Father. Sigurd?
My son, Eivor, by Odin's blessing, come and let me look at you
Stop.
Both.
That is far enough.
Blood of Tyr, what happened there? A grievous wound you have. Are you well?
Far better than I look, I assure you.
This calls for a toast. Your journey must have been long and cold. A drink to warm your blood!
We are not here to drink or make merry. Only to look upon the rackets of a once great man.
And then what? Make new war against King Harald? Stake a claim on his crown? Is that your wish? To sow more chaos here?
You're absurd, old man. What could possibly interest me in this frozen backwater?
Interest you? You robbed me of my wealth when you left for England. I presume you would do it again.
Not my idea.
You left us with nothing when you pledged for King Harald. We took only what we deserved.
I have returned for one reason only. To say goodbye. And to thank you for your colossal failure.
Failure?
As a father, as a king, as a man. For without it, I would not have discovered my true self.
My failure, as you call it. My oath to King Harald was the only sensible path forward for a man in my situation.
There was nothing sensible about your betrayal. Sigurd should have been king. You robbed him of that.
Who did I betray? A son who was never home? A selfish boy with no sense of leadership? An arrogant
strangler? You lie! I have led numberless men into battle, and countless ships and raids across all the known world!
You talk of kingship as if it were a matter of counting the notches on your axe. But to lead means so much more. I passed my crown to Harald because he was a man who understood the challenge put before him. Unlike you.
You pathetic worm!
Sigurd, this is not why we came.
Plans change.
As do hearts.
Not this one.
And you, Eivor?
I wish you whatever peace you may find in this new life you have found.
I did not find it, Eivor. I chose it. The only way forward that did not lead to more violence and death and grief. Your father would have understood. He died to avoid a similar fate, to save his family at the cost of his reputation.
No. My father, he was...
He loved you. That is all.
Argon nonsense. I've heard enough.
My son, please.
Sigurd, wait.
I have spoken my words, and he has spoken his. And from this class came bitterness. What more need be said?
I wish you well, Sigurd, in spite of all that has happened. I hope you find what you seek, and that it brings you peace.
It will. Our destiny awaits. Do not linger long.
I know you love him, Eivor. I know you trust him. But do not follow him blindly into darkness or despair.
This sad business is finished. Good riddance. But now we sail for further shores. To my true purpose. To my destiny. To the end of my road.
I will follow you as far as you wish in this world, brother. But if you mean to take us further, I may reconsider.
I do not think you will, Eivor. I think you will marvel at what I have to show you.
Still dwelling on your father?
Not at all. I was only reflecting on my visions, wondering at them. How present they are, like memories of yesterday.
Describe them for me, your visions.
My earliest was of a large door, embedded in ice, far north of Hörðafylke. The saga stone embedded at the top of its arch. As the visions grew stronger, the door opened, revealing many things. The life tree Yggdrasil, the golden fields of Valhalla, and the faces of our gods, all of whom called me friend, brother, warrior. I felt at home among them, warmed by their love.
You should know. You're not alone in this. I too have had visions.
Have you? And what did they foretell?
It is hard to say. I've seen Odin leading me into shadows. I've seen spinners weaving wild destinies from pools of blood. I saw the great beast Fenrir, the branches of the world tree, and a man with...
Go on.
Valka warned me of a great betrayal, but what form it takes, I cannot say.
I see.
I hold to my oaths, Sigurd. You know that. Betrayal is not in my nature.
Of course not. You are a stalwart as a pillar of stone. Come now. My destiny awaits.
Let's go.
Run up the sail!
Hitler!
Daughters of Aegir, bless our passage.
Yes, I feel a great calm as we cross these waves.
This ordeal with the Elf King, Alfred. How far have you pushed him? Does he bend? Will he break?
Guthrum's army will be chasing him across Wessex now. With luck, he'll push Alfred into the sea.
Strange how these earthly concerns seem so distant to me.
But we've gained so much in England, and we stand to win even more.
The Christians are hardy folks. They see one man above who holds the axe. One man higher than us all. That is a powerful few.
We hold our own axe. We swing it where we may.
The woman, Fulke. In my time with her, as painful as it was, she showed me things. Things so strange and wonderful, I am almost grateful for her treachery.
What she did to you was cruel beyond measure.
Yet, with every snap of the flame, with every scar, the loss of my arm, my visions grew stronger.
If you can find the good in that, fine. But she was as mad as the ocean's wide.
Even the mad ones can offer wisdom. Their Jesus was an odd fellow. Now half the known world loves him, and no one believed us when we were young, and we chiseled our plans onto tables in meat halls. Not even my father.
There is the Sigurd I know well. Can we not return to England and finish together what we began?
No, forget all that. The future is forward. A great wealth awaits us.
I am with you, brother. Until the end. A white rage stands in our way.
Keep moving forward!
You know the way.
As I know my own mind. We will cut through this winter sheet like swords through straw. Do not worry.
To perish on a lonely fjord would be the shame of our clan.
Ha! That we would!
Sigurd, can we not wait for this to pass?
Ah, the sting of ice on skin! Revel in this, Eivor! We walk the footpath of the gods!
To where, more glaciers and deserts of snow?
To glory!
Could we not wait until this tempest quiets down? With this ship where we have mead and food to warm us?
No! We must confront the omens and honor the gods! They will not seek or find you! We must go to them!
We would be poor company with frozen bones and ice pellets for ice.
You need not fear the cold, Eivor. Where we are going, the winds and snows cannot touch!
It is bitter cold.
That's wind from Niflheim.
Keep steady! It should not be far now!
Frozen fingers, I hope so.
There. A frozen lake. This must be it. And ahead lies a cavern.
Will you not say where this leads?
You will see soon enough.
Too late to turn back, I fear.
There! The cave! Within hides the sacred gate! The ice looks fragile. Can you clear it? My heart races. This is it.
Gods, this door. Have you seen this before? The space above. The Saga Stone sat there, did it not?
Long, long ago, yes. Now stand clear. Svachoi nokvat unshmembro trurvondi kvorde unsolas vras chnokadide. Unsum huchas reisterae chasaunsi.
How did you do this? Where did you learn these words?
I told you, Eivor. My visions are memories of a life once lived. Come.
Gods. What is this place?
Over here. This plate will lead us onward. Ho era si. There! The old tree! The tree of life!
What is this?
See how proudly she sits. How beautiful she gleams. Here, all the roots of life run together.
Skulls would cry to behold such a sight.
And there is more to come. I swear by all the names of the Old Father, this is only a taste of what I have in store for you. For my visions go further, to Odin's great hall. There. Do you feel that? The sacred energies.
I have never seen something so grand.
This shrine is ours. It will open for us. Watch and see for yourself.
How do you know these things? Was all this in your vision?
All this, and more.
Is that Svala? Belka's mother? How did she come to be here? Is that Svala? Belka's mother? How did she come to be here?
Yes, it is returning to me now. This ancient shrine is set alight by the sphere of metal. These shining arms, these branches, they will grant us access to the refuge of the gods, to Valhalla. Are you ready?
Sigurd, take great care. We should not tinker with the tools of the gods.
You speak for yourself, Eivor. For I am no mortal. I see that now. I know it. Take your place at the center there, and you will see.
What is this place? Eivor, Tyr said you would come. Welcome. Are you Velka's mother? Svala? You have a keen eye, Wolfgist.
After all this time, Eivor, we have arrived. Now raise a horn with Freya here and sing a victory song.
Sigurd, what is all this? Your arm has returned, and your vicar as well.
Glory eternal, Eivor. Here we dine in the great hall of the slain, at long last. Oh, I want to scream with joy.
This is all so beautiful. Your visions were... they were real.
The battle arose! Come, dear!
To the field! Fight with us!
Go, Eivor. Enjoy the fight. You have earned your place here.
Hold it!
The strength you have. This place is incredible.
Enough with those short flies. You and I must fight.
The battle we never had.
And hold nothing back, for here we need not fear a thing. Fill the eternal lord of Valhalla.
At last I share the din of ancient battle with the truth. Brother.
Worry not, Eivor. For we earn no scars here, only battle wisdom.